Greetings, YouTubers. Long time no broadcast. Well, that's probably because I've been a bit busy. And also it's been Christmas, of course. that's caught it. And of course we've all had these horrible colds for the last 3 weeks. However, this does not mean that I have not been painting. I've been doing quite a bit in the last few days. So I was going to show you that. I was going to show you what's on the bench and what I've completed so far. Okay, so hang fire and here we go. Okay, first up, what I've been doing are some of these Prince August Cast Yourself Cheval Lances, and they're not the worst Prince August models I've used, but they're not far off. However, they are lances, so I've got a few more coats of paint to do on these because they obviously need quite a few coats. But they're coming on. So at the moment I've got 8, but I've got another 6 pre-cast, so that'll get me up to my 12, and I might do another one to make it up to 13 or find an officer figure to go with them. So that's that little lot. These are very much a labour of love, I have to say. Because of course I bought the wrong primer as well. I bought a satin finish primer, which means the paint just slides off, which is a bit naff. So I've had to start repainting them as well. All trial and error, isn't it? As you get on. But we'll see how we get on with these. I think this one is possibly going to be the closest to the effect that I want. If I just bring him forward here. Just get these lot out of the way. So this guy here is going to be, have I got enough light there? Yes. So he just needs a bit more greenery done. And the horse needs to be probably finished as well. So, and I need to work on his helmet, misses. But that's beginning to look a bit like what I want. So we shall see. Okay, so I've been working on those. Next up, I finally got round, I've been wanting to do this for ages and ages and ages, to starting on the Devils in Skirts, the Highlanders. So
1980's no, Top of the Pops.
Mm-hmm.
What are you doing up there?
Right, that's a better picture after that brief interlude. I don't know, you can't get the staff. So, yes, as I say, I finally got around to starting on the Highlanders. So I've got 2 test figures here to see how they're going to look. So these are at a very early stage, but I think once you get a bit of colour on these, so obviously the kilts aren't going to stay blue. I'm going to be doing greens and reds and whatever else on there. But they're going to be, that's just the base coat, so. And these are Airfix, so let's, this is another, let's see what you could do with Airfix figures from 40 years ago. So we shall see. As I say, those are the test figures, so I shall be experimenting with those. I do like the wounded guy. So I thought I'd do him first. Okay, so let's see what else we've got. We have some Prince August Cuirassiers as well. That I've been working on. And these are a lot better than the Lancer figures, I think. There's a lot more detail on these. Well, maybe not the faces, but the rest of the... I'm trying my damnedest with these to get a decent effort out of these, so actually these aren't too bad as figures go. I also got myself a couple of new moulds as a Christmas present to myself because I needed Cuirassier horses. So that's what I've got in the middle, is a proper Cuirassier horse, which is bigger than the other two. So I may have to take the other two figures off the existing horses. We shall see. So I bought an officer's horse mould and a Cuirassier trooper's mould. This is the trooper's mould in the middle. Okay, so I'm working on those as well. These are the test figures to see what they're going to come out like. So we shall see how I get on with those as well. And as way of a change, I decided to start on the wagon set. The Talleri wagon set, so I shall be getting on with that as well. I'm having a lot of trouble getting the horses stuck onto these tiny little sprues here. I may have to trim the ends off and just super glue them. Actually, might be the only way around it, because they're a pain. So I might have to do that. So I'm also working on those. And I've started on the foot guards that are the second part of the Italeri British Line Infantry. So here's my first test figure for those. I've got all the rest primed, ready to go, but I was going to do him first, because it's quite nice to actually do individual figures for a change rather than doing huge batches and actually see where you're getting. Also, I have started on some Saxons, which are in actuality if I just get them out, some of you may recognise them straight away where they come from. I found a box the other day which I've got a load of Lord of the Rings figures in, and these are Men of Rohan, and they're essentially Saxons, so I'm going to paint these up as Saxons. And I also found Eomer in there, so I'm painting him up as a Saxon leader as well. So I've got seven of those. I might find some more scattered around, but it's a bit pointless having your Vikings if you haven't got any Saxons, so I shall be adding those into the mix. And finally, well, not quite finally, but getting there, I based, or I'm in the middle of basing, my first foot artillery. So I've just got to paint that, put some flock down, and that's the first battery done. And another three of those to go, which I've virtually completed painting the figures. So I just need to stick those on and get the filler out. So that's that as well. And I've reached a similar situation now with the dragoons. So I've just got to paint the base filler on those, and those will be done. It's taking me a while to get to this stage with these guys, because again I drop with the green. It's not a good colour. But they're looking quite nice. I might do a bit of dry brushing on the feathers, just to make them stand out a little bit more, but they're essentially done. So that's taken a while to get to that stage. So because I've just about finished them, that's why I've started on these other little ones now. So there you go, that's me. So one final thing. Yes, hang on one moment. Now, I mentioned in my last video that as part of the Advent challenge I was going to finish some pikemen, and here they are. I finished painting these guys quite a while back, 8 years ago, if not more, and the pikes have just sat in my toolbox for 8 years. So as I was creating boxes the other day for boxing up all these figures, I thought, why don't I just do that? Why have these guys just sitting around without pikes for all that length of time, and how much effort is it going to take to do the pikes? So it didn't take that long to do, but it was very satisfying actually getting around to doing it, as it makes them functional at long last. So very happy with those. I shall just do a quick spin around. So let's see if we can zoom in a bit. Okay. So what I'm going to do just to finish them off is do a bit more work on the bases, because they've been battered around a bit. So I shall reflock those, put some bushes, that sort of thing, maybe some stones on there, just to make them look a bit more presentable, because these were one of my earlier efforts at basing, which was the let's just chuck something at it approach at the time. So, but I'm quite pleased with the figures. Do a little bit more of a wash on the sleeves just to pick out the detail. So when I've done that, I'll put them up again. Okay, and Happy New Year to everybody, by the way. And if you haven't checked out Diomede's blog, it's well worth a read, following his little tales of derring do in Hull. A by no means non-violent city, of course, in the Civil War period. And I'm enjoying that, so a shout out to Diomede there. Get a read of his blog, encourage him, help him along. And also notice that British Legion was shouting out that he'd already got his salute ticket. Well, I will definitely be going to that. So, who knows? I'll probably bump into British Legion if he's going to be there all day, which no doubt he will. And anyone else who shows up, hope a few others do go down. It'll be good to see you there. Okay, take care, guys. Bye-bye.